Hello, it's Amanda, and I wanted to come to you briefly on a topic, and that topic is God is our source. Now I stand on, they overcame by the blood of the Lamb and by the word of their testimony. One of the other popular social media sites, I won't even mention them today, is not allowing me to save my live links here. So it looks like I'll be going live on Instagram from here on out, because I know that you'll allow me to save my live videos here. So again, it's no need for me to mention that other company or that other social media site. Obviously, they're discriminating against me here, and I don't want to be held in contempt of, you know, defamation or anything here. So you know what my social media sites consist of here. So let's jump into the message. We refuse to allow that devil to get us into a place of offense here. Matter of fact, we decree and we declare that whatever the weapon is formed, it shall not prosper here. Let's get back into the message. God is our source. And again, I'm not here to counsel you. I'm just testifying. Hallelujah. God is an amazing and incredible God here. Now we take this time to reiterate that God is our source. In Genesis 8, it tells us, as long as the earth remaineth, there'll be seed time and harvest. God is a God that gives seed to the sower. He also gives bread to the eater. Now when we're looking at these horrific situations that are occurring, like what happened in Tennessee yesterday, tragically, the shooting at a grocery store here, we bind up and we cast down copycat attacks. We decree and declare, God, undergird and strengthen the civil workers and the people there here. What a horrific experience to be going to replenish your goods for your home here and to experience such terror. God, we cast down and we evict every form of terror that exists here. And we decree and declare that God is lifting up a standard. When we look at situations like what we saw in Kabul here, hallelujah, where hundreds of people died at the hands of a Unabomber, a horrific act of terror. And even some of those citizens have come over to the Philadelphia area. We're praying, God, that they smoothly transition into life, hallelujah, to fulfill their life's missions and purposes. Even those who have not experienced that type of terror, we decree and we declare God has given us angels charge over us to keep us in all of our ways. We speak healing throughout the earth realm, even as we're seeing what's happening globally here. We decree and declare, no evil shall befall us, neither shall any plague come nigh our dwelling, because God is our source. Hallelujah. What I might end up doing with that other video is recording over that video and posting it anyway here, because I refuse to let that devil steal here. I can't say it exactly like I did in the other video, but what I will say is that God is our source. God is a God that can supernaturally restore from a previous time that we sold here. Hallelujah. I like what one of my teachers say, we're not taking sides, we're taking over. God is a God that will change policies and rules, because who shall lay anything to the charge of God's elect? It is God that justifieth. We realize that we need God in every area so it can be supernatural. Supernatural creative miracles that only the God of heaven can manifest. We bind up demonic oppression. Deliver me from the oppression of men, and then I will keep your precepts. God is a God, hallelujah, that can do the miraculous. When everyone else has cast you down, we serve a supernatural and miraculous God. We bind up demonic extraterrestrial sciences. Hallelujah. We cast down and cancel premature, untimely, and sudden death. And Hezekiah faced the wall and he prayed. Hallelujah. When it was prophetically decreed that he was going to die, he faced the wall and he asked God for a supernatural sign. Not only did God extend Hezekiah's life, but he gave him great wealth. His social media sites showed up. He was wealthy. He was prospering all over the place. We serve a God that will grant us long life. Oh, shayat mamanta, you need to be shouting when I say that part. Hallelujah. We're talking about the fact that God of us is our source, and we don't have to worry about what man can do. Hallelujah. Man wants to nitpick here, but they don't know every hair on our head here. For God knew us before we were formed in the womb. In order for conception to take place, that sperm must fertilize that ripe egg, hallelujah, that travels through the fallopian tubes and plants safely here, divides and multiplies in his humble home, hallelujah, for the next few months, and then a delivery, hallelujah, takes place where that baby is born. We speak safe deliveries and pregnancies, no complications. We outwardly decree and declare that God is a God that will preserve us from all evil. He will preserve our soul. We're talking about God is our source, not even as it just pertains to resources. The government is not our source. Our enemies and frenemies are not our source, even those that we love, hallelujah. God can use them, for he tells us in Luke here, given it shall be given. Good measure, pressed down, shaken together, and running over, shall men give unto your bosom. With the same measure you give, it shall be measured back to you again. But God is our source. We cast down familiar spirits, demonic initiations. Be broken For God is no respecter of person here. We cast it down. We say, God, confuse the language. Hallelujah. Of every demonic tower of Babel here. This is what we're casting. We're casting the fact that God is our source. He's overriding demonic limitations and marginalizations, moving by his spirit because he has given his angels charge over us. Oh, I'm so excited and looking forward to what God is doing for you, my friend. Standing in faith that wherever the weapon is formed, it shall not prosper. Why? Because God is our source. I'm talking about healing being loose, peace of mind. Whatever it is that you need, God is going to manifest it for you. The God that is faithful to the thousandth generation, for all have sinned and fallen short of the glory of God. We're not going to cower down during the pressure because we know that God is our source. And we also know that all things are going to come together, that God be glorified. I'm looking forward to hearing your testimony. May the Lord add a blessing to the sharing of his word. Until next time.